welcome. I'm Sister Mary Elizabeth Schweiger, Prioress of the Benedictine Sisters of Mount St. Scholastica, and it is with great pleasure that we welcome you and that we are able to host the Benedictine College Chamber Singers under the direction of Dr. Tim Carlson. We are so blessed to have you here. And as we begin, we would just invite you, if you have your phone, to make sure that they're on mute, please. In Psalm 98, we pray, sing to the Lord a new song. And for the past 160 years, we have been praising God in song in our daily liturgy of the hours. We are grateful that you joined us for offering a celebration of song. Thank you.
I got it until it was green.
Yes.
I have to turn the mic on until it was green. I was given instructions. Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for being here. What a joy it is to sing for this occasion and in this beautiful space. It's such a privilege for us to be invited to sing here. Now, the first two pieces that you've heard have been done quite often by the Bennington College Chamber Singers, the people of Amarillo, the Anjou's Domini, who is a staple of the repertoire of this choir for many years, especially under my colleague, Dr. Ruth Kruzmark, who you'll hear later on. And the second piece has become a real significant piece for the choir and the fact that we have been able to tour Italy a couple of times and sing that setting of O Sacrum for the liturgy in some pretty interesting little spaces like the Papal Basilica of St. Paul's outside the walls, St. Peter's in Vatican City, you know, these little churches from time to time. But what I've tried to do tonight is showcase music that fits wonderfully in this beautiful space, which almost anything sounds good in here. But what we try to do is find things that are very fitting of what's happening and what can we create in the space, also fitting the occasion. And with that being said, this next piece of music is, it's just a necessity. We're at a Benedictine monastery, we need to do some Hildegard. We just have to. And there's no better person to lead the sopranos and altos of Benedictine College Chamber Singers in a piece on Hildegard than my colleague, Nisanya Beitner, who also happens to be my wife. But she has been studying the music of Hildegard for a long time and really brings it to life. And so fitting to have one of the doctors of the church represented in this beautiful monastery. So here's O Fromme to you.
Hang on, I'll show you.
I'm not going to talk after every piece, I promise. I do want to talk about these next two pieces. We aren't doing them back or like without any pause or anything, but they're very different pieces. The first piece is actually by a Swedish composer named Anders Edenrock, who is a member, or a longtime member, he just retired, of a Swedish group called The Real Group. And this is actually more of a pop song, if anything, but it leans closer to vocal jazz than anything else, but has a beautiful, beautiful a message. And again, make sure you realize that all of the texts are printed in here in your program for you to follow along with. But Friendship, followed by a beautiful piece of music by someone who I've spent a lot of time studying, the stunning composer Arvo Pärt. I think you will love the sound of St. Patrick's Breastplate in a section of this, but I want to tell you that one of the main parts in Pärt's music is the silence. And in fact, at the end of this piece, he writes out the amount of silence he wants after the singers have stopped, and it's included in the piece. So I will make sure you understand when the piece is done, but really, I think, he says there's nothing like this in his music, but I've studied a lot of it, and I think part of it with this piece is that he's wanting us to meditate in the silence on the words that we've just heard. So, two very different pieces. Hope you enjoy them both.
Thank you.
We have a special treat for you this evening. Dr. Friesmark, would you like to tell us anything about this piece? She says no. Aww. She's retired, so she gets to choose when she speaks, I guess. This is a very special thing for us to be able to sing tonight. This is a new setting of single gifts written by Dr. Friesmark over here, who's going to be accompanying us on the piano. But this was written for the 160th anniversary celebration of the sisters' community. So it was recorded by some of the sisters a couple weeks ago, but this is the first public performance of it, the world premiere, if you will, of Simple Gifts. And we're so excited to be able to bring this to you. Here you go.
Simple gifts, 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 simple gifts
There's Green. Such a lovely setting. Thank you, Rick. Thank you for playing with us. This next piece I'm telling you is a bit different. I want you to read the text. And I think if anyone in the room understands this text more than the rest of us, it is this beautiful community of sisters. This is about praying and time. And I will tell you that there's some interesting things about this piece. It was written by my mentor from KU, Forrest Pierce. And one of the first things you're going to hear, actually the first thing you're going to hear, in the score, it says KNG without any vowel to sound like an Indian tabla drum. It sets up this idea of time ticking and time. And if you notice, we pray until the prime. We pray and watch and watch and pray and pray and watch and watch and pray. It's a really, really cool piece. And you don't get to hear it very often because it's also extremely difficult. So here's Shortest Time, followed by a beautiful setting of prayer by Renee Clausen. The text, by the way, I left this out of the program and I was so mad. But the reason I put this piece on the program is not just because it's stunningly beautiful. The text for prayer was written by Saint Teresa of Calcutta, who has been in this room. That's why we are programming this. She visited, and correct me if I'm wrong, it was 1980? 80, right? She visited this beautiful monastery in 1980. There's no way I wasn't going to include this piece. So, here's Shortest Time by Forrest Pierce and Prayer by Renee Clausen.
Thank you.
Thank you. This next piece is a bit of a surprise. It's also a gift. It's meant to be a gift. When we were asked last spring to perform this evening, I was already thinking about, okay, what rep do I want to do in that space? Because I've conducted in here before a few times, and I'm like, ooh, it's just the best. And I was trying to figure everything out, and I was driving to Arkansas with my wife, and we were talking about this, and I was like, what are we going to do on that concert? What should we program? And I said, I want to write a new piece as a gift to the Sisters of Mount St. Scholastica. And she said, wouldn't it be really cool? By the way, these are the conversations that happen in our Toyota Tacoma. She says, you know what would be really cool? Is if you wrote a piece about the moment, the last night that St. Scholastica and St. Benedict were together. And I was like, yeah, that would be cool. But I need a text. Well, I wrote to my friend, we were actually going to Little Rock, Arkansas to see a friend give an organ recital. And I wrote to my friend, Eben Tate, who lives in Wales. And he wrote the text for my Flora tune, which is a cantata about the life of St. Benedict. And I said, Ewan, what do you think of this idea? By the time we got home 3 days later, I had the beautiful text that's in front of me. And commissioned him to write this text. This piece is about that night, and also about 3 days later, when Scholastica passed. There's one thing that I want you to try and realize about this piece. Composers do things like this, but we don't always tell people. This is what I do want to tell you. The entire piece is based around one pitch. In this particular piece, it's the pitch A. At any given time, you hear sound. One of the pitches you're hearing is A. I also had to decide if the piece was going to be in three, so one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, or if it was going to be in 6/8. One, two, three, four, five, six, one, two, three. They can work the same way. Three seems more on edge to me, and I chose three. The one pitch sounding at all time seems on edge to me, so that's why I did it. I have a theory. I don't know if I'll ever find out if I'm right. I think that Scholastica knew that was their last time together. And that's why I created this piece in that way. This sort of tension of it, this idea of, is this our last time? I could be wrong, but it makes for a great story. This is the world premiere, known except for a couple of people have heard this piece. This is the miracle of St. Scholastica.
Thank you.
What a great audience you've been. Thank you to the sisters for inviting us and welcoming us into this beautiful space to make music with you and to sing for you. It's always the thing where you need three things to have a successful performance. You need to have someone to write the music or tell people what to do. You have to have people to bring the music to life, but you also need people who listen to that music. And you have been such a wonderfully attentive and supportive audience. We appreciate you. And we are celebrating with the sisters this monumental 160th anniversary. Wow, it's so awesome to think about that. The wonderful things that have happened because of you being in this community. This last piece, I'm gonna just tell you, we've been singing it all year. I still don't know what it's about. I think it's just got a simple message about a bumblebee and being humble. And I don't know much more about it than that, except that it's a lot of fun to sing. Thank you for being here tonight. We hope you have a safe trip home and go Ravens.
Quincy Singh. Many, many years in this chapel singing. What a tribute you gave to us tonight. Thank you. I also want you to know that we understood that last song completely because we have two beekeepers.
Of course.
And we have bees all, and our beekeepers talked to us for an hour this afternoon about the spirituality of beekeeping and community life. And so we could understand what they were singing about. It was exciting.
And there's still people that think there isn't a God.
That's right. We have a gift for you in the music department that we'd like to present to you. This is an icon of St. Scholastica that was written by our sister Paula in 2012. Know that you and the students will be remembered always. In fact, if any women would like to join the monastery, our singing would never be the same. We want to thank you all for coming tonight to celebrate with us. We will continue this celebration all week, and on Friday night, we will have a conference together in this chapel at 7 o'clock. But the evening begins over at Benedictine College, where the students and faculty are invited to walk over with lanterns and join us for our evening prayer. We have dug cookies for you as you leave tonight in the foyer. And then we very humbly would like to offer to the chamber singers and to you our blessing. And if our sisters would stand, extend their hands, and if you would open your hands to receive the blessing.